You're new to DaVinci Resolve and you want to level up your videos using custom and seamless zoom and slide transitions without having to study Fusion? Well, I got you. That's what you're going to learn in today's video, but you want to make sure to stick to the end because I'm going to show you a very simple and smart way on how you can save those transitions so you don't have to recreate them in all of your projects.
First of all, you obviously want to have two video clips, one that you transition from and the second one that you transition to. Then you want to go up to the top left corner of your screen to where it says Effects. If it's not already open, just click it. Then go down to where it says Effects once again and then grab the adjustment clip at the top and drag it onto your timeline just like so. Then go to the beginning of your timeline, hold the shift key and hit the right arrow key to jump exactly 1 second forward in time. Now I do this because I want my transition to last exactly 2 seconds. If you want to have a shorter transition, you obviously want to choose less frames. So what I want to do next is I'm going to go to the end of the adjustment clip, and when my cursor turns into brackets pointing left and right, I'm going to click and drag it to my cursor. Then with this adjustment clip, I'm going to click it, drag it to the end of the first clip. Then I'm going to hold my Alt key, left click the adjustment clip once again, drag it up and to the side to duplicate it, and then drag it down to the start of the second clip. Now move your cursor over to the first clip and then select the adjustment clip, right click and go to open in Fusion page. Now with this open, again, bear with me. We only need one node to finish this transition. Then I'm gonna select my media in one and I'm gonna go up to the toolbar right here and select this transform tool and just click it. This should automatically connect the transform one in between your media in one and your media out one. However, if it doesn't do that and it's just floating in your node editor just like that, you wanna click it, hold the shift key and drag it up until the line changes color and then let go of the click to automatically connect this in. On the transform one now, you wanna go to the first frame of your composition, which is frame zero. Select the frame zero. Then you wanna go to the top right of your screen to where it says inspector. If that's not already open, just select it. Set a keyframe on center X, just like here. Then go to the last frame of your composition, which in my case is frame 23. I'm gonna go to frame 23 and then I'm gonna move the center X to 0.25. Just a little bit towards the left. So with this being done, you can see now we have blank edges and that's totally not what we want. So in the inspector, once again, go to edges and select canvas and change that to mirror. Now you have a mirrored edge, which is totally fine for this transition. Then you wanna go up to the top right of your screen once again and select the spline tool. If it's not already open, just click it. Then with the spline tool open at the bottom right of your screen, you wanna hit this button, which is the zoom to fit button, which shows you your keyframes. Then you can highlight those keyframes by dragging a box over them. Hit S on your keyboard and now you wanna put the lower handle a little more towards the right and change the upper handle just like that down to have a nice easing curve. So with this being done, you want to go back to your edit page, just like so. Put your cursor over the second adjustment clip, select it, right click once again, go to open in Fusion page. And now with this clip being open, with your media in one selected, you want to go up to the toolbar once again and add another transform node, just like so. Then you want to go to the first frame of your composition, just like here, again, frame zero. Then you want to go to the top right of your screen where it says inspector. If that's not already open, again, just give it a click. Set another keyframe, but now for this time, because we're sliding towards the left, we have to start this frame out from the right. So I'm gonna offset my center X here to 0.75 to move this towards the right. Then again, I'm gonna go to my last frame of the composition, which in this case is frame 23 again. Select it, go to center X and just type in 0.5 to move this back into place. Then with this being done, you wanna go down to edges, canvas and change that to mirror once again. Then you want to select the spline tool in the top right corner. Again, press the zoom to fit button to see both keyframes, drag a box over them to select them, hit S on your keyboard. And then you want to make the opposite. You want to change the lower handle, put that up just like so. And then you want to choose the upper right handle and drag that more towards the left side. Something like this. And if we now go back to the edit page and play this back, we have a super smooth and seamless transition. Now it's not quite perfect yet because we don't have motion blur, but I'm gonna show you how to fake that motion blur. So Select one of those adjustment clips, doesn't matter which one, hold the Alt key and drag it up by one layer to create another duplicate. Then move this duplicate exactly in the middle to this cut, just like so. Then you want to right click this adjustment clip, go to Open Infusion page, and there you want to just delete the Transform One node. Now select the Media in One node, hit Shift Spacebar, and type in Directional Blur. And just add the directional blur in between the media in one and the media out one, just like so. Now, first of all, you wanna go to the top right of your screen to where it says Inspector once again and change the blur angle to 0. Then you wanna go to the first frame of your composition, which is frame 0. And obviously at the start, you don't want to have any motion blur. So just decrease the blur strength in the inspector from 0.4 to 0. Set a keyframe, then go to the middle of this transition, which is frame 11. Increase the blur strength quite a bit, something like that. Then you want to go to the last frame of your composition, which is frame 23, and then you want to decrease the blur strength again back to 0. Now with this being done, you again want to open up the spline window if it's not already open, hit the zoom to fit button, and now in this case you're going to see 3 keyframes. So as we've done previously, just drag a box over all of those keyframes and hit the S button to smoothen them out. And with this being done, we don't have to change any of those angles. So let's just go back to the edit page and play this back. This should be a super smooth and seamless transition with a little bit of motion blur. Now, if that's too much motion blur for your liking, just decrease the middle keyframe a little bit. So now with this being done, I'm going to show you how to create a super smooth and seamless zoom in or zoom out transition. And therefore, we're going to go to our first adjustment clip, select it, right-click it, open in the Fusion page. Again, just you can either delete the Transform One node, or you want to go to the inspector in the top right corner and click this button to reset the Transform One node. So in this case, I'm just going to reset the node because we need a Transform node for this one as well. Then I'm going to go to the first frame of my composition. And in this case, I don't want to set a keyframe on center X and Y. Instead, I want to set a keyframe on size. So set a keyframe on size on 1. Then you want to go to the last frame of your composition. In this case is frame 23. Go there, set another keyframe on 0.75, just like so. And again, now you see we have blanking edges once again. So go down towards its edges and change that from canvas to mirror. Now with this being done, you want to open up the spline window once again, hit the zoom to fit button, select both of those keyframes, hit S on your keyboard, and now you want to drag this one more towards the right, the upper handle, and drag the lower handle a little bit more up to create a nice easing curve. So once we've done that, we want to go to our second adjustment clip, right click, go to Open Infusion page, and again, you want to reset your Transform One tool so you have a blank Transform One, or you can delete it and create a new Transform One. Then you want to go to the first frame of your composition. Then you want to set a keyframe on size and type in 0.75. Hit enter. Then you want to go down to where it says edges and change that from canvas to mirror. Then you want to go to the last frame of your composition, to frame 23. And again, reset the size back to 1, so just type in 1 here. Then you want to open up the spline window in the top right corner, hit the zoom to fit button, highlight both of those keyframes, hit S, and now you want to drag the lower handle up just like that and drag the upper handle, the right one, a little bit more towards the left. And then you're good to go. So go back to your edit page. So we have to adjust our third adjustment clip. So select that, right click, go to Open Infusion page once again. And in this case, you want to delete the directional blur because we don't need that in this case. Just hit backspace, go to Media in One, hit Shift Spacebar, and type in Zoom and add the Zoom Blur. Now with the Zoom Blur added in between, you want to go to frame 0, decrease the zoom amount to 0, then you want to set a keyframe, then you want to go forward to the middle of your transition, which in this case, again, is frame 11. Then I want to increase my zoom amount quite a bit, something like that. Then I want to go to the end of my transition to frame 23, and then I want to decrease my zoom amount again back to 0, something like that. Open up the spline window in the top right corner once again, hit the zoom to fit button, highlight all three of those keyframes, hit S on the keyboard, and then you should be good to go. So go back to your edit page and just have a look what we've created. So now what you want to do in order to reuse those adjustment clips in each and every project that you're working on, all you want to do is click on one of those adjustment clips, drag it into your media pool, just like so. Then again, use the next one, drag it into your media pool. And then the third one, drag it into your media pool, just like so. Drag them back onto your timeline, just like so. 1, 2, and 3. Then what you want to do is go to your power bins. If you don't see those power bins, what you want to do is go up until you see DaVinci Resolve. Then you want to go to view and you want to go down to where it says show power bins and make sure that is checked. If it's checked, you should see the power bins, and then just select the power bins, go to master, and then you can maybe create a new bin in here, call that transition, or call that maybe zoom transition. Hit enter, and then with all of those three adjustment clips selected, go into your zoom transition folder, drag them in just like so, and now you have them stored. And now from there, you can just drag and drop them into every project that you're working on.
All right, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment, because this would mean a ton to me, and it would also help the channel to spread this video out even more. But anyways, if this video was a little bit too easy for you, you might want to check out this more advanced fusion transition tutorial that I did quite a while back. It's a Luma Fade, and we're dipping our toes into the Anim Curves feature, which I'm sure a lot of you guys would love to know more about. So, otherwise, I'm gonna see you next week. Have a good one. Bye.